Now we're into our second phase of our skull boiling video, and we're actually going to be removing the flesh, you know, and the brain matter, you know, from these skulls in our little boiling pot. I got them started a little earlier today, but a little bit of a recap. After you remove the hide, you want to cut off as much of meat as possible. The reason for that is when you're boiling your skull, if you have a lot of fat and meat in here, it can taint the bones and it's just more of a mess to deal with. If you're going to be boiling a head, you know, in a camp, you know, look out your fire safety. Make sure you do it in a good clear area. If you're doing it at home, I don't recommend doing this in your kitchen, especially if your head's got a little bit of a taint to them. It's going to really stink out your house and you're going to have to find a new place to live. So do this outside in a, you know, fireproof area. These were our heads from last time. I've had these boiling for only about 30 minutes so far, and you can already see a lot of that flesh and that brain matter is coming off. And we're doing a full skull and a skull cap here, whatever you choose to do. This one is going to be kind of referred to as a European mount. When you put them in the pot, the bone is covered as much as possible, and the antlers are covered as little as possible. That's kind of the key to boiling a head out, because it can bleach out your antlers. I just want the top of the skull just barely in the water or a little bit out of the water. And we don't want to boil these skulls. You want to get your pot up to boiling. Once it's boiling, I'm going to add, you know, just a, not very scientific, a couple of squirts of soap, a couple of pours of detergent, a little splash of borax. And once it's boiling, I'm going to chill that down till it's, you know, not really going to boil. It's just a simmer once it has been boiling. Babysit your pot. Look at it every once in a while. I have a bucket of water here, one for fire control if I was outside. Two, to just make sure I have enough water that it's just barely covering those skulls. You want to, again, babysit it so it doesn't overboil. And the other reason to babysit it, if you forget about your pot, all your water will evaporate and you'll burn your skulls. We'll come back here in a little bit and we'll see how we're progressing. I'll go over it with a knife here real quick. We'll let it dry and that's, you know, ready to transport out of a CWD zone. It's nice and clean and dry and it's looking good. I'll put that one there. Here's our full skull. And you can see, you know, a little bit ago, that one looked like this. And now, you know, it's looking really good. Now we're just gonna scrape all the flesh off of it. One of the big things is you gotta remove the brain out of there. Again, if you can do this outside, if you can save your chunks, dispose of them well, the stuff is boiled, but CWD can still, you know, live in that brain matter. So try not to get it all over a campground or your remote site. That's exactly what we don't want to happen. So if you can kind of save the brains, put them in a bag, get them in a dumpster is the best place to, you know, get rid of this stuff. Before I get in the brains, I'm going to put on a pair of gloves. Really, with all this stuff, you should wear gloves. Some of this, you know, loose stuff, I'll just do with my fingers, and then I'll get in here with a knife and I'll scrape it as well. Okay, I'm going to pick around here a little bit, and then we'll come back. I just kind of did a little bit of a rinse off on this skull. Again, we're kind of getting there. We're almost CWD compliant, but we've got to get brain matter out of brain cavity. So again, use my handy dandy coat hanger that I just bent an end on. So what I'm going to do is I'm just sticking that brain hook in there. I'm rattling it all around, trying to move the membrane out. We're just scrambling that out. There's quite a bit to come out, and it goes pretty quick. All right, we'll come back when I get that all done. From when we started our boiling to where we are now, this one took about a half hour, and that flesh was ready to go, and it was nice and clean. I just picked that off, and now we're letting it dry. This would be a CWD transport-ready skull, looking real good. Our skull here, remember these nose pieces here will pop off. You should probably put those in a little bag and glue them on. They'll just pop off like that. But our skull is good to go. A really good idea would be just to fill that brain cavity up with borax, you know, for your transport. You know, the most important message, I think, from our whole video is, you know, this is not CWD ready. I mean, we've got brain material in the back, we've got flesh, we've got fat all over it. You know, this one would have to be, you know, boiled out if you want to leave a CWD area with this. If you do leave a CWD area with this and you're contacted by a fish and game officer, biologist, or if you bring it to a regional office, they can't let you leave with this. They're going to have to cut it so you could leave with this part, but the brain material's got to stay at our office or in the CWD zone. It's a very, very important message.